Evening folks, this is BestInSlot, and we are of course back building our Planet Zoo campaign build thingamajiggy, our mammoth of a campaign build, to say the least. What are we doing today? Well, we finished off bronze in the last video and we're on to silver now, and what we have to do is have at least 9 habitat species in the zoo and increase our conservation rating to 2. Now that's not so hard, that's climbing up steadily, but 9 habitat species really is the big goal, so we're going to carry on working on that today. As my buffalo's moo in the distance. Would it be a moo? I think it's still a moo, isn't it? In the last video, we built ourselves a little red panda habitat, as you can see in here. They are in need of new food, actually. Oh, they're having a little snooze. Oh. And today, we're going to move on and try something else. So, we're going to kill this tree. This tree's in a bad place. Tree, you have died. You've sacrificed yourself for the nation. I need to bring back my railing on ground path, because that's what we're doing, stylistically. Or something. And we're just going to drag this along there. Lovely stuff, lovely stuff. And we'll stick some more education boards on there and also some donation points as well. One there, one there, one there. This campaign mission is humongous. I know I've mentioned this before, but I do want to just bring that up again. It is massive, it really is. It seems I can't grab those. Let's grab a few more of these education boards. Slide them into the gap like so. Lovely stuff. Very sexy. Very sexy. We'll just do a couple of them, I think. Yeah, no, we'll do 3. We'll do 3. One more. I really wish this didn't happen. Is it N? N doesn't seem to be doing anything. There is a hotkey to disable the heat maps with your keyboard, which would be very helpful, but what are you going to do? No power. Right, we'll have to sort that out, obviously. Red panda, red panda, and red panda. Lovely stuff. Right then, let's move on with our lives. So today, we're going to work on a couple more exhibits. The first one I want to do is the... Oh, no. Okay, well, I want to get rid of this path. It's actually the first thing I want to do. There we go. Lovely stuff. It does look good. I'll give it that much. It looks cute. And that's important. Cuteness is really the most important thing, I think, if we're honest. So let's get some lights in here. I think we'll just light up. Obviously, oh yeah, we need some electricity, don't we? Who is getting angry? We're about to get some bebbies. You have low welfare. Why? What's up, my friend? You just need some food? Okay, we can hook you up. Don't you worry. About to get some baby flamingos. Right, yes. I believe we have already in stock a couple of useful animals. There we go. Yeah, we've got a couple of Nile monitors. So that's going to be our next habitat. We need to keep an eye on maturity. Because we need to basically make sure that our exhibit animals aren't excessively breeding. It's actually good money and good conservation points, but... Our back drink. Oh, Monk's Essig, finally! Why are you in a box? He's just very excited. He's decided to box himself up. Something's going on with this enclosure. Why has it gone crazy? What is going on? The game's gone mad. Has it gone mad on all? Yeah, they've all gone mad. What on earth is going on? Has anyone seen this before? I had something vaguely similar like this happen to me the other day, actually. I couldn't rename any of my signs. The game has... Honestly, it's been busted a little bit lately. I'm going to have to restart. We'll save it because we've done a little bit of work, but I'm going to have to reload into the file. I can't unbox. I can't do anything with my exhibits. How bizarre. Okay, let's log back in. Hopefully that'll fix everything. So we're going to do a Nile monitor exhibit because it's a smallish animal and it goes well with the red panda. Remember, we're doing like a small animal area. We've got the red panda, we've got Nile monitor. We also have our 5 exhibit animals in the very same location. So, are you working now? Yeah, there we go. See? Like, I knew it was broken, right? And I hadn't done something wrong. It just needed... There we go. No, when you're in a... I don't bloody know. Right. We'll have to sell... Monk Setsek is going to move on to a new life very soon. We are going to work on our next enclosure. So let's flatten this bit down here. I just want it to sit right here. You're going to walk down, you're going to walk past both of them, and then we're going to end up curling down there. It's going to be pretty cool. So let's get started. I'm going to keep this one fairly chill as well. I'd like it to start earlier than the red panda, I think. But we're going to try and give it a slightly funky shape. Let's get funky, funky, funky. Is this already a bit big? You know, it's okay. And then we can have let the path go in there. That'd be cool. Oh, my Timberwolf died. I think that is just of old age, though, so don't worry. And this is why we have to keep an eye on our exhibit animals, because as soon as their children are born, they need to be sold. Otherwise, they kind of, you know, cause a lot of problems. I think we're good there. Yep. This is good, though. We get to release them onto the wild. We get conservation credits. And we get conservation rating. It's all good stuff. It's just something we have to keep an eye on as we play the game, really. Oh, Monk Setsek, you've been a good lad. You have. It's time now for you to go and experience new things, you know? And there we go, 116 points, baby! And we got our conservation rating. Good stuff. Right then, let's I'm gonna leave it on play just till daytime, and then I'm gonna pause it again. I think. Yeah. It's a weird world where I can say, oh, that's fine, my animal's dead, but it is genuinely okay. Why is that red? What is going on today? I swear! There's something, like, just crazy wrong with Planet Zoo at the moment. It's been doing this fairly consistently as well. Like, it's not like a new thing. It's been consistently bizarre with me lately. What we'll do is we'll go down there, we'll go like that, and we'll just join those up like so. A little bit longer. Nice. That'll do. Don't want to make this too complex. It's slightly uneven, which is upsetting me to my very core, but we're going to get over it. That is bizarre, isn't it? How weird. I wonder why it's doing that. I've never seen that before, I don't think. It must be because of the lighting, right? We're in this sort of sunset kind of temperature at the moment. Oh, and the Kedra, I am sorry. But now this opens up the gate for, you know, other wolves to get their mate on, basically. Oh my god, there's a lot of people looking at my dead wolf. That's no good. Okay. Ah, no, we may have a problem here. Do the Nile monitors require water? Can I check? Let's see if we can check. I may have made a mistake here. I only just realized. Damn it. Okay, right. Okay, right, so we're moving the Nile monitor. They can't go here anymore. They're gonna go down here instead. It's gonna be cool. It's gonna look really cool. We're gonna be like down here at the entrance to the water. I might honestly go into like a bit of a ramp system here, because it just isn't gonna work otherwise. And they'll look better anyway, I think. So we're gonna build them down here, and then you're just gonna walk past and see them from above, I think. So let's give that a go. Let's see what we can do. They don't need lots of water, they just need a decent amount. So I think we're gonna go across like that. I honestly think that's probably good enough, right? Come on, you can do it. No, you can do it. I saw you do it, just very briefly. Okay, now you've gone mad. There we go. When the game tells you it can't do something, just ignore it, alright? It's lying to you. It can do anything. You just have to push at it a little bit. Right. I would love to find an animal that can live in multiple habitats so we can speed this up a little bit. Like, I am totally down to chill and take our time with this build, but it's going to be like 7 episodes on one bloody thing at this rate, so. Alright, I actually have no idea how I'm going to do this. I think what we're going to do is a teeny tiny little staff path. Teeny tiny little staff path. That goes like around underneath the guest path, like so. It's pretty cool, right? I like that. Oh, I've made a mistake. We need to turn railings on elevated on as well, and then replace this with this. There we go. It's the kind of thing you would usually build yourself, but because we're playing on campaign. Yeah, okay, cool. Thicken that bad boy up a little bit more. Lovely stuff. And then I think we're going to drop down in a little bit, anyway. There we go. I like that. That's going to be cool. That's going to be cool. Right, we're going to pause it here just because, well, we can. This is the time. There we go. Let's get those little boys into our zoo. I don't want to say that sentence ever again. did I actually attach the staff gate? Yeah, it's over there. Let's drag this right down. And I think we might make it into this mesh as well. Because I think it suits this kind of animal, you know? And also it's got the water, and the mesh kind of suits the water as well. I want that, like, right above the water's edge. That's cool. So it kind of blends into the ocean. The water. The wet bit. It blends into the wet bit, right? That's what we're getting at here. And it kind of matches with the flamingo as well, which is using the same stuff. So maybe our sensual ones are all going to be made out of the mesh, basically. Do, do. Are you floating? Oh god, they're all floating. Oh god, the horror. What is it with the lampposts and floating? I mean, it's totally my fault, don't get me wrong, but I'm still going to complain about it. Alright, let's get rid of them. Come here. Come here. Thank you. Are you floating? No, you're chill. Right, so let's grab all of these. Let's drag them across a little bit. Drag them down a little bit. There we go. That's better. Looking good, boys. Looking good. Although, looking very uneven, actually. You need to go that way a bit. You need to go that way a little bit. That's looking better. Right. So we need to get some power in here. We'll put that down here because... Oh, is that going to work? I'm wondering if this will annoy guests to kind of walk above it. I imagine it will. I don't think that's actually a big deal in reality. Maybe what we should be doing is researching... What are you researching? You're researching Asia for me. You're nearly done, actually. Maybe we need to research some power options. That's a good idea. And we can do an enclosure over here as well. And the idea really is you're just going to walk around the lake. I think that's where we're going to build. Right, let's get our Nile monitors into the exhibit, and then we can work on making it attractive for them, basically. We're gonna get there, folks. We're gonna get there. And all the stress, that's fine. About to get, yep, more babies. Saren Gerel is about to have some bebs. Is it just stress? Enrichment. Do you really not have full enrichment? Okay, we can look at that. I'm a little surprised it's that low, though. African buffalo. Will that help? Nope. Will that help? There we go. Food enrichment. That might be a problem. Is that really not? Oh yeah. Okay, there we go. I think it might be just because they had a kid. So, there we go, there we go, there we go. They had the kids, so they need more enrichment to kind of balance things out. Now, are we happy, my little Nile monitor friend? Other than the lack of enrichment, terrain is looking good. Sweet. Let's kill that. Obviously, we'll decorate the enclosure and stuff like that, but as long as they're happy with the basal stuff going on, then I'm happy. What I kind of want to do, thinking about it, I want to do the hippo over here, right? Lots of water. But maybe in the middle, we can build like a fountain or like a big statue rising up. Just something in the middle of the lake. It's kind of like the centerpiece of the park, you know? I think that's cool. I think it's a good idea. We shall see. You're very old. That's worrying. Yeah, you're a little bit old for my liking. No harm, love. Like, I don't mean to be mean. Species, Nile monitor. Do we have anything? Yeah, we've got a few things here. Let's see what we can do. There we go, and one more toy. Sweet, 100%, very cool. They need a water pipe, just in case. And they need probably just a small food tray, if I had to guess. There we go. Do I have, is this water being cleaned? I think if we clean one part of the lake, it actually cleans the whole thing. Yeah, so that's actually cleaning the whole thing. That's actually super helpful. Very cool. Right, done, basically. Now we just need to make it sexy. Which means, I think we're going to go... We should probably go tropical. No, I was going to say we should probably go grassland, because that would kind of fit better. But we've gone grassland already. So we're going to be a little bit different on this one, and we're going to go tropical. I just want to see if I can push the amount of grass up first. Without annoying them, basically. That's going to obviously look better as a base for the tropical. Need a bit more soil. Need a little bit more rock. It's kind of like a little path. Like a desire path, as they call it. There we go. A desire path is where a path forms in nature. You know, like where the grass is all matted down and darkened and like worn away. Because that's the route that people want to take. There's actually a university in America. where they looked at the desire paths and they laid the normal path over the top of it, so it kind of sprawls out in this amazing spider web of paths. It's really cool to look at, actually. Should Google it. Nature! We're going to go tropical. We're going to have some fun. We're going to get some banana palms. Sound right. We need to turn off land surface. First thing you do when planting plants, turn off a line to bloody surface. My palms down by the water. Oh, no, maybe these ones. Are set. Yeah, that's what we're looking at. Giving them a little tropical home. It's going to be cool. Not a kapok. As much as I adore the kapok tree, and I do, it's one of my favourite trees, it is too big for this environment. It'll dominate everything, you know? And you'll see it from miles away, so it'll ruin the other enclosures. I miss playing with this stuff, you know? These kind of textures were always my, like, favourites. Tropical really is my favourite set in the game by a mile. That's why I'm so excited about the new DLC pack. It's just made for me. It's not only is it giving me tropical, but it's giving me bloody ruins as well. It's everything I want. I don't even care about the animals. Like, I know that sounds stupid, but the animals are, like, a minor point of it for me. They really are. Do, 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 do. Let's get some rock. Is it savannah? No, it's desert, isn't it? I think I'm using savannah in my other park, and that's where I'm getting confused. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. A bit of a stack right there in the middle, you know? Mix it up. You wouldn't expect the stack to be in the middle. That's why we're doing it. Subverting expectations. I should write for Game of Thrones. Probably would have done a better job. Well, hey. Nice modern reference there, you know? Very controversial. Game of Thrones final series was bad. Up votes to the left, please, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Dude, I love doing this. Like, part of me looks at it and thinks, well, really, this campaign, I should be speeding it up, we should have finished the campaign by now, blah, 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 blah. But why not just enjoy it, you know? Why not take your time and build things that you think look nice and try to do something a little bit different? Everyone else has finished the campaign. To be fair, if the Arctic pack hadn't come out, we probably would have finished it by now as well. I don't know why the rocks are floating, but let's roll with it. Tell you what, let's just do one big stack. I love my stacks. Stacks on stacks on stacks. All it takes is a little bit of rotation to make every rock feel special. And every rock should feel special. I've still got a cold. I tried to do a fake sniff there as part of the joke, and instead I'm like... Oh, God. I'm so sorry. That's a nice-looking little habitat. I am happy with that. Oh, I'm not happy with that, though. Jesus. Can we do anything about this? Yes. Tell you what we can do about that. We can hide it within the rock. I don't think I can do much else. There we go. Yeah, that's cool. Looks really nice. I'm really happy with the zoo, honestly. It's definitely my best campaign zoo. I mean, it makes sense. I've actually put some time into it, unlike every other campaign zoo I ever did. So, now, this whole area needs some love, but I think that'll look better when there's more enclosures around there. Like, maybe this path can, like, curl out like that. Maybe. Like that, and kind of go around the staff path and then link up again down there. Something like that. I want to smooth this out a little bit. It's a little bit iffy. Oh, you're not going to let me because of the path thing, are you? Ah, that's okay. It kind of looks like a staircase anyway. Right, I think we're actually near enough done with these guys. We need some decos. We need some donation boxes. And we need some education signs. I was going to make my own. I still kind of want to do that. Like, make a custom design for the education boards. But clearly I'm not doing that, so. Get that nice and straight. We good? Very slightly off. Can I just turn this into a group? Yeah. Make that into Nile Monitor. Very cool. Very cool. Very sexy. And we're going to just put these at the... Where are you going, buddy? you've gone on a little adventure. You have gone on a little adventure. That's fine. Adventures are cool. I do not blame you. I kind of want to keep it off the middle just because it's going to block the viewpoint. It doesn't actually block the view, but in theory it should. I think that's enough reason, but whatever. That's fine. A little bit to the right. Okay. Yeah. Happy, happy, happy. Right. We could actually do a double habitat for once, because I'm pretty much done with that one. I really don't have any problems with that one as it is. Maybe need some decoration around there. The whole thing needs decoration bloody everywhere, though, so... let's have a little look, then. We should be on 6 here. We need 3 more still. Let's have a little look what's in the market. So, we've got Timberwolves already. We don't have Snow Leopards. We don't have Saltwater Crocs, but they're going to need a lot of water. We don't have any elephants because we can't afford them. We can afford a hippo. We can get brown bears. It's a rough animal, this. I need something cheap. We can get gharials, but again, not really here. Orangutans. Do we have bears tapir? I don't think so. Right? I don't think we've got bears tapir. I think that might be the next animal on our list. It is. I'm going to have to build 9 habitats. It's actually going to have to be 9 individual habitats. There's just no way it's not going to. Ah, that's fine. Oh, they're all female. I'm just going to grab 1. I tend to just get the youngest. Let's check on our birds. Can they live... I mean, most animals is 1 male, 1 female. It's just the way it is. Yeah, so we'll have to keep her on her own for a little bit, but hopefully we can get her a bay fairly soon. Everyone needs a bay. Oh, I didn't realise I didn't do that, but... Oopsie daisy. Right. Well, not everyone needs a bay. I was totally joking. I wasn't joking, I just said the words and didn't think about what I was saying. Just for reference, it's totally cool to be single. I was single for like 6 years. It's totally chill to be single. And like, you shouldn't feel pressured. I know so many people who feel pressured to like, you know, get married and have kids and all that rubbish. And if you're getting pressured by your family, I understand that it can be, you can feel that pressure, but it's your life. Do what you bloody want. Tell your family where to go. They're not the ones getting married. Society is big on pressure to get married and settle down and have kids and stuff. And if that's what you want to do, that's totally chill. It doesn't mean there's anything wrong with that. But it does mean that it's not for everyone, you know? I'm not even single and I'm saying that. You know, it's... I think you've got to be... I don't know why we're going off on this tangent, but we are. I think it's vitally important that people are happy being single. I think it's 100% necessary. I think if you aren't happy being single, then you're not going to be happy in a relationship long term. You have to... You know, love yourself and all that kind of jazz. Have to love yourself a lot if you're single. Oh, this is going to work really well, actually. That's nice. I don't know. I know what I'm getting at. Why would you not want to love yourself, eh? Okay, that doesn't look as cool as it did in my head. I'm wondering if it's because of that path like that. If I can fix that, yeah. Let's try that again. If I just leave that like that, first of all, it should go in pretty perfectly. Let's try that again. Yeah, that's why I wanted it to happen. Cool. Okay. Bed's tapir, let's go. And then we'll spend the rest of the video doing some decoration stuff once this is set up. It does still need it. It's a little bit of a boring enclosure, but that's fine. Everything's coming together. I mean, that looks quite nice, right? It needs a little bit of love here and there, but I think it looks pretty good. I love this bit here, actually. I must say. I must say, I'm immensely talented. Oh god, right, okay. Let's grab that, and that, and that, and that. I'm gonna control X, we're gonna rotate you around with some angles snapping on. Choo, choo, choo. And now what we can do is... Wait, how they're not... What? Oh, I'm so confused. Oh, whatever. It's fine, it's fine. Just stick them in there. That'll do, that'll do. Alright, are you on your way? Did I already do that? Yes. Let's get the tapir in and then we will design and we'll do some decos and we'll just make the whole thing look pretty. Sound like a plan? Sound like a plan. Alright, yeah, and we'll do a new keeper selection for... Well, tell you what, we're actually doing really well money-wise. Money is just kind of rolling in at this point in time. So we're going to hire another keeper. And we're going to give them a new work zone. And it means I kind of want another staff building as well. Although, isn't that a keeper hut? No, it's a facility. Let's get a keeper hut. Do, do, do. I think part of it is just carry on my tangent. At the end of the day, right, I do these videos, and there's a lot of time in these videos. This is 25 minutes already, we're not, like, nearly done. You know, these tend to be 50 minutes or so videos. They're longer episodes. If you don't like that, that's totally understandable, but I think it makes sense for the series. And I think if I just talk about Planet Zoo, I'll bore myself more than anything else. I think for the good of myself, I need to talk about other stuff, so it's going to be whatever pops into my head. And this is something I'm genuinely, I don't want to say passionate, but it's close to passionate about. I think it's very important that people feel free to be themselves and to be in a relationship with yourself. What's this? This is tapirs and monitors. I'm going to call it Baird's Monitor. And we're going to assign our new staff member to Baird's Monitor. Where is he? She, I should say. Lizzie Crockett. There we go. Cool. I think everybody has... It's two exhibits per work zone at the moment. Let's get this tapir delivered. What's up? Is it staff? Oh, no. What's going on? Food enrichment. Really? Is that really a problem? Let's have a little look. See if we can do anything for our flemings. Looking for... I got one of these. I love these things. Where do I want it? Yeah, that's cool. They do need food enrichment. Oh no, they've got a forage bowl. We just need to get it in somewhere. Yikes. Can we get it in somewhere less ridiculous, please? Oh, that just flows. Nope. I mean, it is fixing them, but... Okay, we can fix that though. What we do, what we're going to do, we're just going to grab some rocks. And we're going to create like a floor. Essentially. Need a big cladding rock. I need one of these. Just so it looks... it doesn't have to look amazing, but it does have to look like it isn't floating. It's really the minimum that I'm looking for here. Don't be a floater. Where's my big boy? There's my big boy. Big boy, you are the perfect rock for this situation. I actually quite like it. Looks pretty cool. It's kind of like a multi-step look to it. I like. Yeah, cool. Right, they should be a lot happier now. Okay, moving on. Where is my blimmin' tapir? There it is. Now, first thing first. Do we have enough space on a basic level? Oh, they need water. Oh, I can't do anything about it. How do you have hard shelter? I can't do anything about it. I just can't. This map is horrendous. There's like such a limited selection of animals and so many of them need water to survive. I think we're just going to have to get on without it. I think it's going to be okay. So it's a very small amount of water that it requires. We'll give it like a really nice moist looking environment and that'll help. That's my theory. It's not a good theory, but it's a theory. Alright, let's sort this terrain out. I need less sand, so let's get some long grass in there. Long grass. A little bit too much long grass. Not enough soil. Ah! There we go. Perfect. I mean, everything's at 100, so what's their habitat? Oh, lack of plants and lack of hard shelter. So actually, the terrain is 100%, so you actually don't need the water to make them happy, oddly enough. Okay, cool. Let's work on our Baird's tapir. I'm hoping we get the Malayan tapir one day. I know it would basically be a, you know, a copy and paste animal, or like a Reese skin, but I really like the Malayan tapir is my favourite tapir, you know? I think it's most people's favourite tapir, actually. Which one do we like the best? That was cool. Give them a nice big house. Hide it at the back, though, just so they get to... So wait, is that big enough? Yeah, I think it's fine. Ooh, it's a bit close, though, isn't it? Ah, that's more like... I really like to hide. I don't like being able to see the wood, basically. I mean, who wants to see the wood? But this way we can... There we go. Lots of bedding. Nice and cozy at the back. Right then. Need a pillar. Need a food trough. Ball. Ice ball. How are we doing? food enrichment. Do we not have any food enrichment? No, we don't. So we're going to have to get some research going on the tape here. Look at that baby! Sorry. I'm going to specify for the bears just so we can keep an eye out for a male. It's all females at the moment. Usually that's good, but right now it's kind of a pain in the butt. Right, so plant life. Plant life is important. Maybe I want to do a... Ooh, I've got a plan. What we're going to do... It feels mean that I think about it and say it out loud, but what we're going to do is like a fake river, right? And the idea is, this was once the bear tapir's environment, this is where it lived, blah, 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 blah. You know, obviously the water provided sustenance for the tapir and for the environment, but the lake, because of the location, the river, whatever, has dried out over time. And we can still see it, but it's a bit of a mess now, basically. And it's not moist in the way that you would want it to be moist. I like that idea. And we'll put like some rocks across there to do a little bit of a bridge, maybe. There we go. Maybe a big chunky boy on this side as well. Cool. Yeah, I don't know, we have to do something to make it more interesting. Now, let's get some plant life in there. That's the stuff we want to see. We're looking for South Central America, soon to be much, much more interesting to build with as well. And again, we're just going to go pure tropical, I think. When I think Baird's tapir, I think tropical. Oh, the lily pads. So sad. Yeah, the palms are pretty cool. We got some palms. Because the palms are tropical, but they also kind of suit the deserty vibe we've got going on in the rest of the park as well. So it's a cool combo. I'm going to stick with the Akes. Acai? I swear I've heard people call them Acai before. I call them Akes. I always have done. But I could be entirely wrong in doing that. Right, okay, yeah, I get to mess around with this stuff. It's like My Pen Rye all over again. I love it. Very cool, very cool. And thankfully, because the tapir is a baller, we can put loads of plant life down. It's gonna look really nice. No more big trees though. Swiss cheese plants, always one of my favourites. We can just, honestly, smack them around everywhere. Just stick stuff in and hope for the best. Elephant ear plants, also one of my favourites. These are going to, for reasons unbeknownst to science, they're going to chill by the feeder, like so. Just cover that up a little bit. Maybe a little bit over there. Maybe a little bit over here. Who knows? That's the fun. Maybe some of them sunk down into the earth. Inexplicably sunk down into the earth. I don't know. I just want it to look different than the other exhibits, I guess. One mangrove tree roots shown up as the water has disappeared from the lake. Custard apples, of course, beloved custard apple trees. Back there by the shelter. It's nice to cover the shelter a little bit because you want it to be somewhere they can actually hide out, you know, and feel protected. Okay, I might be going a little overboard. we're going to put some vines on this as well. I need a land surface. Land surface, I've besmirched you many times. This is where you earn your stripes. Your comeback has begun. This is always a very weird one for me, this, because look at it. Look at the shape. Look how it goes upwards. Never understood why you'd want that one. Cannot wait for the new vines as well, if I haven't mentioned those already. We're going to get these new ones. They're like thick tree trunk roots things popping out of the stone. It looks awesome. You know what I haven't been doing? Is decoration at all. You know, like construction decoration stuff. I think it's because of my lack of... I think I need like the Asia theme. I don't really have any props. Not good ones anyway. God, I've got barely any. Ah, there's a few up here. I mean, this is all useless. All the Arctic stuff. What am I going to use that for? We could use some of this. I think I've used that a couple of times. You on the fence? Yeah, you on the fence, cheeky little blighter. Why not, eh? Why not? One in the middle, one in the middle. It's a thing now, I've decided, it's a thing. I'm gonna lead into it. It makes sense, it's got the kind of, you know, tropical plant life. That one is way too high up. It's got that kind of look to it, you know, it looks like a leaf, you know, when you zoom in on a leaf. God, that's a disaster. They all are. Alright, let's get rid of you, come on, buddy. I think it's because it's this one's a lot closer, so I actually can't fit it in the gap. So we do it manually like so. Same with you, you cheeky little blighter. Come here. There we go. It's got a little bit of style. Not much style, but it's got a little bit. I think we just need to get researching some more stuff. But there is a lack, I will say, of South American decorations in general, you know? There just isn't that many of them. Unfortunately. We don't have a South American theme pack. So hopefully the new stuff we get in the South American pack is going to do a lot of good for what these exhibits look like. Right, with all that done, we can go back to general decoration stuff. I'm going to craft some wisteria. I'm going to push this basically all the way along here. Little gaps for the education boards. Yeah, I'm using the same one, but I don't think you'll really notice. Make that a bit more themed, and we could do with putting some plant life in there. And we need some education boards and donation bins. This is a useless donation bin right there for the tapir as well. So we'll do this every two. So I'm looking at the thicker points of the fence and using that as a reference, essentially. And some education boards. Right, where's my stuck together ones? They're my favourite. Come here. Come here. Thank you. Is that good? Over than it being an Nile Monster, which would be very confusing for some people, I'm sure. We're looking good. Looking sexy. The kids say. Do people say sexy? I've never really liked the word sexy, if I'm totally honest. We use it in videos because you gotta make it sexy. It's a reference. What is it even a reference to? I've been doing it for so long that I've forgotten. Gotta make it sexy. I cannot even remember what that's a reference to. That's very upsetting considering how much I bloody say it. Right, anyways, let's hop back into nature. We're gonna go for... Were we using North America? There isn't, I mean, it should be South America. It should be South America. Because this is, well, South Central America. But there's nothing here. You know, because we're in Mexico. Are we in Mexico? I think we're in Mexico. Wait, are we in Mexico? I'm going to say we're in Mexico. Can I check? No, it's Nevada. Oh, it is America. Why do I think we're in Mexico for some reason? Okay, right, anyway, no, we're fine then. The sticks and deco was in. It's anything to make it look a little less dull, essentially. I'm gonna move for a. Where's the big one? Yeah. A nice manzanita bush. Big fan of the manzanita bush. It's very evocative and large. That's what I look for in a bush. It just looks so much better already. It's crazy what sticking a few plants in can do. It changes the whole vibe. I'm going to go for nettles here. We've been using the flowers, but why not mix things up slightly, you know? Just a nice... Stop floating! Just a nice row of nettles going all the way along. Kind of like a little backdrop. Just squeezing there. Lovely stuff. Nice and easy. Is there a longer one? Yeah, that one. Stop it. Just be cool like me. What's wrong with you? That's fine. They won't... The tapir is not going to love that being in their exhibit, but it's also super not a big deal whatsoever. So, what are you going to do? Should be tapir. You... It's really hard to tell. Come here. Just sit there. Thank you. Jesus. Yeah, that looks really nice as well. And although they are nettles and they are, you know, part of the desert environment, they actually do suit, I think, the tropical theme quite well. They look perfectly tropical, you know, it just looks like a nice big flowering plant. I might put it along there as well. Why not, eh? Why not? I know we haven't spent much time with our actual animals yet, but we will. Just been busy. Got to get my deco on. Do-do-do. Nearly done, I think. Yeah, pretty happy. I'm really happy with this, honestly. We need a bit over here as well. This is lacking a little bit in the decos, I would say. Your little one. I want, like, a little one. Oh, Josh. So many trees that I keep forgetting to include. Joshua. I'm sorry, Joshua. Creote bush. I changed my mind on that very quickly. I went from, it's actually pretty cool. I quite like that. Let's just get some grassy sort of textures in there as well. Which is always actually really useful. I love bushes in this game. Bushes in this game are like criminally underrated. They are possibly the most important thing when it comes to foliage. Just stick foliage everywhere. Honestly, just do it. Just put foliage everywhere and it brings your zoos to life in such a real way. It's awesome. This is not like a high effort zoo to say the least, but I think it works really well. It's crazy. Just the foliage in this game is the best. And that is why I'm excited for the South America pack. Because as much as I'm sure the animals will be great and I'm excited to try them out, honestly, loads of new foliage options, loads of new decoration options, that's what I get excited about in this game. Way more than the animals. I know that's sad, but at the end of the day, right, when you're doing franchise mode and stuff like that, as I'm doing, or when you're doing sandbox mode, what do you spend 99% of your time doing? Building. You don't spend it with the animals, you spend it putting down foliage, you spend it, you know, building things. It makes sense that it's the most exciting bit. That's my justification, in a way. Whether it's going to fly or not, it's another kettle of fish, but I'm sticking to it. Are we going to do our fancy... Yeah, let's do our little thing for this one. So we have a style. We need to put the roof on first, I believe. And then, I need to try and remember how he did this. It's a style, we're kind of aping the style from the entrance. Yeah, we did it over here, so it's that. What is that? Glass modern wall, and then glass opaque roof. Glass modern wall, so that goes on... There. So it also stacking back on. And then we're looking for opaque. I'm looking for that. And the reason we're doing that is because that's actually how some of the buildings at the start were stylized. So we're just going to keep on using it, basically. Now, what I'd like to do is copy everything in that group except the hook. We're going to drag that along. We're going to bring it over here. And this is what we're going to do in the future. This is going to make my life a lot easier, hopefully. Oh, wait. Why is that not working? That should fit perfectly. Why is that not? I'm very confused. Why would that not work? What? I will make it work. I will make it work. Up a bit. Okay. It should have instantly done it, so I'm a little confused why it didn't, but it ended up fine anyway. Right? Yeah, cool. Alright, good stuff. Good stuff. What do we need? What do any of us need? What is love? I want like a big tree behind this. It's nice to have... I don't want to like to look at the hut and see the whole world stretching out beyond it. You want backdrop. Same with over here. We need trees and stuff behind here. Maybe some rocks. Maybe we'll do like a big old stack of rocks. Which is very unlike me, I know. We'll put the big Joshua tree in again. And then we'll grab some desert rocks as well. And we'll do a little stack here. Blend it into the mountain a little bit. You're too nervous. Okay. Cool. Now, this bit behind here is also a problem. I think we're going to terrain tool that. I don't want to just go too hard in the rocks. I want it to look natural wherever possible, so. There you go. Nice and natural. Exactly what I wanted. No word of a lie. I'm going to pull that across. And then, as I am wont to do, we will attack this with a... Am I going to use chisel or... Yeah, I'm going to chisel mood. Let's chisel. I love that. That is my favourite design thing, is having a big stack of rock and then you carve like a hole in the middle of it. I just think it always looks awesome. And we just attack with a chisel. We just needle it in a little bit randomly in it. Creates like a really nice looking rock structure. Beautiful. I'm honestly pretty happy with that. We just need to paint it up with a little bit of rough rock at the top. I tend to cover the whole thing in rough rock. Don't worry, we're not done yet. Cover it in rough rock, and then we get the sand. And just in the flat bits, you just dot it with sand. And maybe a bit more fading in around the bottom. Like so. There we go. And it's looking good. I'm really happy. I'd say this area is basically done. Do we need anything else? I don't think so. Maybe a little decoration, but no, not really. Honestly, the zoo's looking... I'd be moderately happy with this in any build, never mind campaign. It looks like a zoo. I guess that's what I'm going for. It does need some decorations and stuff like that. I just don't know what it would be. I guess we can pick animals that are in the zoo and just hope that there's, you know, like, toys for them. Not toys, statues and stuff like that. But Nile Monitor, Tapir, Flamingo, these are not animals that have statues. Mainly because they're not African, and it's only the African ones that do. Anyway, head down here. There we go. Look down into the Nile Monitor. I do want to do something around there. Maybe with these fences. Maybe with this fence as well. Although I like the glass effect we've got, so maybe I'll keep that like that. We'll do another enclosure right here. So you'll wrap around there. See the enclosure, wrap and join back over here. So we'll do one there. Two to go. We'll do both of those in the next video. And then we'll finally be onto gold. And then we need another four habitats. But that should only be two or three episodes. So we are finally on the cusp of greatness. I might actually do my glass thing on top of that building as well. Might make it look a little bit more interesting. Yeah, let's do that very quickly. Glass maw. Maw. Oh, oh, go back. Where's the wall? There it is. Maybe that's just gonna help that building look more thematically appropriate, as the cool kids say. They do, you know. I was talking to my nephew, he's a cool kid, he's three, and he was like, Connor, my friend, your zoo is very thematically appropriate. He didn't, that would be bizarre, but you never know, imagine. One day I'll get him to say that and I'll record it. Plus, I think it's nice to have one building with the effect on and then the next building next to it not, because it creates this kind of little disparity between the two. It makes one look more important and it just makes them both stand out in their own way because they don't look identical. I can justify anything, it's fine. Oh, I like that. Actually sunk down a little bit. That's cool. It's cheeky. Oh, it's not going to work anymore. Whatever. Ah! Why are some of you doing it and some of you aren't? How bizarre. Why can't you all be cool? Okay, well, we'll see how many cool ones we get. I like it. It looks like a solar panel. You could actually probably build solar panels out of this stuff. And it would look fairly realistic. It's just this far edge. How weird. You know what we're going to do? We'll do it on purpose. Why not? Have the size raised up. I don't know why they're like that. That's why I like it. It is cool. How weird. I have no explanation for why it's done that. Can I change the colour of these? Yeah, you can actually make these. If you made them like a little bit grey instead, they would actually look like solar panels. We can do a little pan or something as well. Okay, right, we are looking good. We're going to end it there. Thank you so... No, we're not. I'll tell you why we're not. Because we have animals and I've spent zero time with them. Let's go meet our Nile monitors first of all. Oh, he's going for a little swim. Can't get out, can you? No. This is Shakira. Oh my god. Shakira looks like she's going on a runner. Oh, Shakira can get out. How can she get out? What is that? Walkable? Okay. Sorry, Shakira. I know you seem like you're about to go for a little bit of an escape there, but I'm going to have to stop you if you don't mind. I don't know how that makes sense, but I guess this is just a little bit too low. It's a shame. Alright, hopefully we're good now. And she seemed to be going over with purpose, you know? Yeah. Well, it works now, at least, I think. Oh, no, not quite. Oh, we're gonna have baby red pandas! Amazing! Have I ever had a baby? Okay, right, they're cool now. So it's Shakira, who's probably who's going for a runner yet again. No, this is Suede. Suede and Shakira. They sound like a lovely couple. Look at her! Doing a little mlem. Oh my god, what a name. Right, our bear's tapir has just arrived. Wait, what? Chal Mecha Sihult. That's an incredible name. Need some enrichment. Now, I'm working on that, aren't I? Man, we don't have any food enrichment right now. I'm sorry, buddy. Social is lower than it should be. The space is suffering because of the water. Habitat's fine. It's okay. 75%. It's not great, but... I don't want to get rid of the nails. It's fine. What's your name again? Chalmeca Sihult. Huilt. No idea. It's amazing, though. Love it. Let's ramp those prices up. Money. What I'm really excited about is the baby red panda. We're going to stick around for that. It's going to be adorable. Bloody, who was that? What was that? Was that the... That can't have been the birds, surely. I have no idea what that was. That was terrifying. I'm going to get you a friend, okay, buddy? Eventually. Yeah. May I need another workshop? I've got one over there. And we'll just go grab our little design over here. And hopefully this time it'll stop being weird. It's just not even trying to latch on anymore. Very strange. Let's get that fixed. How you doing, guys? Oh, who are you? Remind me. Taban, that's the one. Jeez, this zoo is packed. Absolutely packed. I mean, there is a baby red panda on the way. Oh no, there's the baby! Zing. Hello, Zing. Oh, you're so cute. Meh. Oh, look at him. Oh, he's so tiny. Little legs waddling along. Zing. He's the cutest little thing. Oh god, I'm inside his face. Oh my god, it's breaking my heart. He's gonna go for a climb. There's his mama or papa. He didn't look that small, and then you see him in comparison to normal red panda, which is already small, and you can see how tiny he is. Oh! Zing's gone for it. What are you up to, Zing? Oh! He's flying! Zing don't care, he'll do what he wants. Yeah, the climbing in the game is busted. I think we can acknowledge that. Oh, they're all hanging out in the treehouse together. This is actually adorable. Look at them. There's a family of red pandas and they're all together. It's sweet. They're not practicing social. This is terrible for social distancing. Seriously. Awful. Awful. Where's all my money gone? Wasn't I making a lot more than that? Am I going crazy? Get you a drink, buddy. We should actually be able to make these a little bit better now. Oh, wow. No, not that one, apparently. That one? No, not... Okay, what was I doing? There we go. Tropical plant. Hollow log. And this one, I guess? Yep. Large rock. There we go. Okay, yes, we're going to end things there then. Thank you so much for joining me for this last hour or so of Planet Zoo. We will try to finish off Silver in the next video. I don't know what animal we're going to get for that. Oh, there we go. Chimali. Chimali, that's a great name. So, we've got two tapirs as well. Yeah, I don't know what we're going to do. We could do snow leopards, we could do crocodiles, we could do brown bears, we could do gharial. That's about it. We actually are, I think we're going to have to get every single animal, you know, to finish the zoo. Because we need four more animals after the two. We've got six animals still to go. I think we need everything. That's nuts. But the zoo's going really well. We're making a lot of money. All the animals are happy. Everyone's very popular. It's looking cool. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you lovely folks in that next video. Hope you're enjoying the series. If you are, please do hit the like button. I continue this campaign because, you know, some of us, we've been doing this a long time. And some of you have been with me from the start and we've been plugging away on it for a long time together. So if you appreciate that, please do hit the like button. It goes a long way and it makes me feel special. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, what's up as always. Bye-bye. Oh no, William. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.